design your clothes? Is it something that comes to you as a gift, or do you design with a woman or someone in mind, especially when it's another celebrity?
Actually, I don't really design with celebrities in mind at all. Like I had mentioned, you know, creativity comes from the ether, so I really channel the creativity. It really comes through me, you know, as a divine source. And, you know, happen to be very, very prolific. I designed, you know, basically about 1,500 designs a year. Everything that you see, you know, it's 1,500 of them plus a year. So, and also in between stolen moments, I really have designed my homes, my corporate offices, my beautiful, fabulous showrooms. So I think it's just really energy that really comes through us, and I'm very lucky that I really am an open conduit to really receive this very beautiful divine energy, and it just really moves through me, and I feel very honored and humbled by it.
Thank you for that answer.
You're welcome.
How do you shift from the ego to the spirituality and back to a humbleness that you are at home and the people who know you?
Well, you know, I've always been, you know, as an artist, I've always been really more sensitive, so I think I've always really had a very strong spiritual life. It's really never left me. It really entered into me probably from the time that I was 2 or 3 years old, so I've always been very cognizant and aware of my environment, and I started to ask questions, you know, what does this all mean? What, you know, why are we here? What is the purpose of being alive? And in the world, of course, we must really wear some mask, but, you know, underneath it all, I basically feel that the mask is just only a persona that we really wear on or put on. It's really like, you know, putting on a social mask or a piece of clothing. It's not who we really are sometimes. But actually, I'm pretty, you know, you can really ask all the people here that are my personal friends. I'm pretty constant. I really, you know, I'm a very down-to-earth, no-nonsense sort of person, even though I live in the etheric realms, you know, when I create, but I'm actually a very down-to-earth person. Just I'm very no-nonsense, and maybe it really comes from my peasant roots, you know, when I was really growing up as a child in mainland China. We choose our professions for a reason. There is a reason why we choose what we do out in the world. That was how I healed the wounded goddess in myself, by really designing these beautiful clothes for women to really empower themselves with beauty, because you can talk to any women who have really have worn my clothing. They heal through the power of beauty and, you know, connecting women with their eternal feminine divine. Yes, I would say, you know, any art that is created, any creativity that is created, is infused with the artist's soul or spirit. So you are getting a piece of my spirit when you wear one of my clothing. So my mantra, let me explain to you what it is. It's called beauty, period, magic, period, transformation, period. So what I create is the beauty. And the alchemy of beauty is magical. And that magic has the power to transform. So I like to really believe that when a woman puts on a Suwon gown or dress, she is magically transformed into the goddess that she aspires to be.
It's beautiful. What 3D truly stands for, which is the evoke part that we bring forth from beneath, just like the lotus that comes from very deep waters. and we embrace who we are as we are, and we evolve, which is the transformation. And this 3E, the sign itself, it's not connected on the top, but only here. That once the 3 and E face one another, it's as if the body of a woman and that body of woman is perfection with its imperfection. Yeah.